Welcome to Vlogmas Day 1, bitch.
Morning, everyone. The Christmas tree.
We found out the tree is actually 7 foot.
They left it outside yesterday in the rain.
Basically, just to do a little rundown. I don't even know if you want to see me right now because I look gross. But just to do a little rundown. Has ordered a Christmas tree the other day for video of backgrounds and stuff. And obviously, just to have a Christmas tree. Wow, the lighting's amazing.
Bloody.
We've literally just woke up and we got back yesterday at like 3 a.m. Obviously not expecting the Christmas tree to have arrived, but apparently it did, and the guys, the postman will have just left it outside, so it's been in the rain all night long, so it has lifted the box up, and it just dissolved in her hand. But yeah, we've got the Christmas tree. We thought it was tiny, but it's actually the right size. That's not 7 foot though.
Yeah?
Still not 7 foot, I don't think.
No, I think it'll be.
Because I'm 6'1", and that's smaller than me.
Like,
oh, this is cute.
I really don't like how it's like, you have to bend the tree things off.
Yeah, did you think it was little spindles? If they were actually like a form of Christmas tree that represents me right now, that would be it, just that bit. Look at Hazza's Christmas tree, there she is, gorgeous as ever.
Welcome to vlog me.
Sorry.
I know, yeah, well, when I say it's vlogmas. No, she knew I was filming anyway. I'm gonna make an intro now. There is just one thing I need, and alright, so Freya's got the Christmas music on. We're feeling a vlogmas, you know. Freya didn't even realise it was vlogmas today until I just reminded her. I have left it to the last minute. I'm currently sat making my vlogmas intro. Jazz is right there. Clouds will make you happy with a toy or. I've left it so last minute to make my vlogmas intro, so I'm just trying to put something together real quick. And then we're gonna get the day started. I've got so much uni work to do, but. See?
It's Christmas.
Love it. The vlogmas intro is all complete, and I actually really love it. I'm gonna show you it now. In fact, I'm not gonna show it on my laptop. I was just gonna turn my screen around then and be like, watch it on my laptop. But I'm just gonna roll the intro. So, roll the first ever vlogmas intro. Well, not first ever, but first ever 2018. Vlogmas intro, let's go. Now. Or maybe now. I think it's so, so cool. I don't know why I think it's so cool. It's just literally being like, huh? But like, I just, last minute, I think that's really good. So, pat on the back from me. Love that for us all. I'm so excited for everyone to start uploading their Vlogmas vlogs. Like, Zoe and Alfie's Vlogmas is my favorite thing in the entire world. Sorry that I'm just laying in bed, by the way. I have got so much uni work to do. My deadline is on Monday. Today is Saturday, so I've got literally today and tomorrow to finish my entire project and get it all submitted and literally ready to like, press done on the thing, and then I broke up for Christmas, so it's super exciting, and then it means I can go home and stuff as well and get a Christmas tree. You're gonna see all that. I'm so freaking excited. We're having a real Christmas tree again this year. It's gonna be Coco's first Christmas. We may have also got another little fairy friend surprise when I go back home. Right, it's time to make myself some breakfast. So I'm gonna make myself sausages and egg. I kind of just want some cereal, so I'm gonna make myself some cereal instead. I'm praying that I've got some because I feel like I might have used them all. I don't know if this is Vlogmas or me getting copyrighted by Freya's music because apparently it's really loud. Oh, look how pretty the Christmas tree looks. So glam, so cute, so funky and fresh. Right, time to get the cereal ball out. Ooh, this angle's beautiful. I was just literally looking back on my Vlogmas vlogs from last year just because I wanted to see what intro I did. I think I've run out of cereal. And I was looking back and I did so many days. I think I did the full month of December and then 3 months afterwards. I did so much. I think I got like, in fact, no, not 3 months, maybe like 2 and a bit, because I got like 70 something days, like continuously. And I was so annoyed when I broke the, like, what is it called? I'm gonna say broke the seal, but broke the rhythm. Broke the routine is what I'm trying to say. I was so annoyed when I broke the routine last year because I did so much and I just really want to try and do it again, but I just know that it's not gonna happen because my life has just got significantly more boring since then. I hate that. Alright, so you better all be proud of me. It's a few hours later now. I'm just sat on the sofa, as you can see. I got a little hot water bottle. Basically, Freya had it because she had really bad period pains. So she's been sat cuddling this hot water bottle, but she's now gone to work. So I'm literally home alone. There's no one here besides me. My problems have all gone. If anyone can guess what that's off in the comments below, then I will love you forever. I can't actually remember what it's off myself, but I will remember. You will get a cookie if you do remember. Oh, it's Shrek! Damn, sis, we really are out here. It's Shrek. Anyway, we're gonna move on from that. I am now gonna sit and finish off my uni work. I've literally got like 2 slides left to do, and then I've got to write a 1,000-word like evaluation of my entire project. It's all ready to submit on Monday. I am so freaking excited to just submit it. I said it this morning, but I just cannot wait to get it over and done with, and then like Vlogmas and Christmas and everything starts, and I can just live my best life. Also, yesterday I never actually showed you Saf's palette, but I just got the Beauty Bay bag out. Well, I got it out earlier because we actually brought all these flowers home. If you watched yesterday's vlog, you'll have seen me and Haz took all the flowers because the girls at Beauty Bay basically said that they didn't know where to put them. They were going to end up going in the bin. But this is Saf's palette. Well, there's 3 palettes, obviously. The packaging is so, so pretty, and I'm so fussy about visuals, but this is genuinely like dead ass. Even if I didn't know Saf, it's so, so pretty. I'm not going to open them because I'm going to give them to my mum. I also just realized in those last clips, you probably saw this on the table. Now, this is, in fact, a penis warmer, and you may be thinking, Byron, why the hell do you have it? Well, Anastasia bought it me for Secret Santa. So this morning, to start Vlogmas off, I went into the bathroom, put this on. I tried to put this on, and I went in and surprised her, you know. I made her an entire Christmas, so that's fun and fresh and has actually been used. So thanks, Anna. It served great purpose, and I hope you enjoyed it.
I may have accidentally fell asleep. I've just been asleep for like 4 hours. I'm so annoyed at myself. We went to bed at like 5 a.m. last night, which is obviously why I've just fell asleep. I'm just annoyed because now I won't be able to go back to sleep. It's like 9:30, and I'm meant to be going to bed within like the next 2 hours. And here I am, wide awake now because I've just slept for like 4 hours.
Well, Vlogmas day one's just going amazing, so I can't wait for the next 24 days.
What the hell are you doing?
Byron,
isn't it? Wait, what? Show her. Well, we love that for you.
So guys, how's Vlogmas going?
Fuck off!
Hi everyone, welcome back to my Vlogmas. So, it's going really well, as you can see. Nothing's going
wrong. But I lost one of my hands.
It is literally like 2 a.m. Everyone has gone to bed now. Everyone's still awake, but everyone's just in bed. I am currently sat doing some uni work, as I said. I really want to get this all done. I thought my deadline was Monday, but it's actually Tuesday, which is only one more day. And I'm still going to pretend that it's due in on Monday, because then I'll at least have it done. I've literally finished my entire workbook. I'll show you in a second, go through it with you, to show you what I've been up to this past term at uni. But I'm literally just writing my final like summary of it all. We have to write like a evaluation of his entire project, and it's taking me forever because it's 1,000 words and I hate this project. I'm on 644 and I'm literally like, I have no idea what to say. And I know 1,000 words is not actually a lot in terms of like what you've got to write for uni. Right, so this is my workbook. I don't know if anyone's going to be interested in this, but I know a few of you are because you always ask to see my work for uni. Basically, those of you that don't know, my laptop screen's dirty as hell, but I'm studying fashion photography, so this is my workbook. I'm going to go through it really quickly. If you want to see it more in depth, then I'll do maybe like a different video on it. This project was a fashion film. It was called Fashion Interactions, Creating a Fashion Film. So I just made this little layout. We've got little diary entries. Each page looks like this. It's like Wednesday the 26th of the 9th, which is September 2018. That's what that means. Like, so these are like diary pages where I've just been talking about what I've done on that day, what I've learned, etc, etc. Little mood board, and then I'm looking into brands. The brands that I looked into, and then the proposal, the storyboard for it. I hate this so much, but we had to make a storyboard, so I'll let you know what, I'm just gonna do it. Then I've got like a little Urban Outfitters fact file because I decided to use Urban Outfitters as my brand. And then mood board, more stuff on Urban, the stuff that I've previously worked with Urban on. And then I have the artist research pages. I looked into Bryant because I really love this video that he did with Emma Chamberlain and the Dolan twins. I think it's so, so cool. So I looked into that, spoke a little bit about that. And then I've just got a research page on Bryant. And then I did a Bryant Urban Outfitters inspired shoot. Obviously, this is the little teepee thing with Maddie. If any of my lecturers are watching this, maybe don't listen to this next part, but I didn't actually intentionally do this shoot for my workbook. We just made a cute den and I'm like, oh my God, this looks really cute. And then it sort of fits, so like even though I said we purposely did it, it just is to try and make me look I've done more work than I actually have, so like tea. Then I did a page on an Instagrammer called Tezza, and then I did a shoot
I did a shoot again inspired by Tez's work. Then I've got a few pictures on styling. These are all the different outfits and dresses that I looked into, and then locations. And then I have the first shoot. Now I hate all this. I actually changed my idea numerous times in this project, but this was like 2 weeks ago and I decided to redo the entire thing. So I had to keep it in because I was literally so far into the project that starting again entirely was not an option. So I've got shoot number one, shoot number two, shoot number three, shoot number four. All of hers, and then this is the video piece. I hate it, so we're not seeing that. And then I wrote in this thing, I really don't like my idea anymore, basically, so let's change it up 2 weeks until the deadline. And this is what I did. So then I did a new mood board with new things, looked into different photographers again, and then another storyboard of my new idea, my amazing drawings right there. And then I looked into more artists and different photographers. This is fashion film 2.0. So then I started looking into different colors and the color palettes and what I wanted to actually get across and what vibe I wanted. So as you can see, the color palette for this one were pink. And then here is the shoot. So these are just a few photos of hers, as you can see. Just a bunch of photos of hers. And then I went into video editing and how I edited the video and what the thing looks like and the concept and then the music I used and then the fonts I used and stuff and what fonts I were looking into using. And then I have the first edit of my film. These are all videos that I actually play, but I'm not going to play them all, obviously, because it's only quick. Then I played around with the color correcting of the video. As you can see, this is before, this is after. Before and after, very snazzy. And then the project were called Little Black Dress. So these are the final 8 images. I'm still deciding on these, but these are my favorites, I think. I'm just gonna ask a few people their opinion. And then this is the final film.
Hi, yeah, I don't think I'm gonna be coming tonight. I can't find anything to wear, so I think I'm just gonna sit this one out.
Hey, call me back when you get this, or when you've got a minute. We really need to talk. Wait, you know what? Maybe just forget it. Cause by the time you get this, your number might be blocked. Stay and blah blah blah. You just want what you can't have.
Done it, guys. 1,364 words, and it is officially almost 3 a.m. Now it is time for me to go to bed. I swear I never ever sleep anymore. It is currently 3:41 in the evening, in the morning, should I say, and I am not asleep yet. I just finished up editing a podcast episode. I said editing, it's all uncut, but there were a few things I just needed to add. Like, I needed to add like an intro thing, and because it's like a 40 minute, in fact no, it's 50 minutes, because it's a 50 long minute episode, I had to go through and like get the best bits to put at the beginning so like people can get a brief idea of what we're talking about instead of watching the full thing having no clue what the hell it's on about. And that took me so long because I couldn't find or remember what we exactly talked about, so I was trying to cut bits up and be like, make sense of it. Anyway, it's all done now. I'm just currently saving it up on my laptop and then I'm gonna go to bed. I'm not even tired though, surprisingly. Like, I thought I would be so tired, but I'm not. I know, however, tomorrow I'm gonna be really tired because this always happens, and then I get into like a vicious circle of where I sleep most of the day and I'm awake most of the night, and when you're doing Vlogmas that just doesn't work. I think tomorrow I'm going shopping with Jazz. She wants to go shopping at some point. I've got a bunch of more editing to do, but I think I'm gonna go shopping. I'm gonna see what I get done. I'm gonna go and get in bed now. If you enjoyed Vlogmas day one, smash a big thumbs up. I'm so sorry that I've not done anything but like being in the house all day long. You're gonna get this some days, and unfortunately we had to start day one on this note. Anyway, I love you a lot, and I will see you tomorrow with a brand new vlog. Night, everyone.